Hi friends. Happy Friday. Welcome back to Puggsy. I went back to the Aztec games off camera and gave myself a few more extra lives. Also, I looked up what the deal with this room is. And there's supposed to be a few different words that you can carry out of this room that has that have different effects. You can carry out the word cheat, which gives you infinite lives, but it also turns Puggsy green, and anything else in the game that's Puggsy colored will also be green. I don't really need the infinite lives, so I wasn't going to do that one. There's supposed to be a secret message from the developers if you carry out the word heroes. I couldn't get that to work. And there's supposed to be like a little graphical demo effect if you carry out the word other. And I couldn't get that to work either. And those were the two that I mainly wanted to show off. So I don't know what's going on. Like, that might only be in the Mega Drive version. Like, I stacked the letters and I carried them out. I don't know if there's something else I'm supposed to be doing. But I'm sure the footage of the Mega Drive game is probably on YouTube if you want to go look that up. If they took it out of the Sega CD version, I don't know why those letters are still there. I don't know. Maybe the cheat still works, but I'm not worried about trying that. I'll just continue on to the Aztec Temple. Part 2. Well, part 3 if you count Aztec games. Excellent! Yes. That is exactly what I meant to do. Good job, Puggsy. Video games. A nice little sound effect. Bloop. Alright, so there's a crushulator. That's probably preventing me from jumping over to the right. Like, that sure looks like a jump that I should be able to make with the speed shoes. Can I just, like, skip this entire level? Oh, that's fun. That's fun. Yay! And there's nothing down here. There's just a big pit here for no reason. And I left that thing on the other side of the pit. Okay. Awesome. Doing great, Puggsy. I see. So you're supposed to put those logs into the crusher to jam it up so you can get across there. But with the shoes on, you can just bypass that whole thing. I don't think there are any secret exits, so just, let's get it done. Rackrock Forge. Rackrock, I assume, is short for Raccoon Rock. Alright. Ooh, is this going to have more PlayStation buttons? Those things are delicious. Or is it just... No, it's just orbs. Oh well. They're still pretty delicious. Disclaimer, do not eat the Puggsy orbs. Okay. So, there's the number 6. So does that mean I need 6 orbs to open the door? There's a question mark under the 6. So am I supposed to do what comes after 6, which is 7? No, I think it's probably just 6. Okay. Does this go anywhere? Some of the doors are decoy doors. Oh, Pugsanoid. Hooray. It's like Arkanoid, but not. There's an extra life. And I guess I need to break all of the blocks to open up the exit. But if the extra life falls down there, does that kill me? No, it just, well, it'll kill me eventually. Okay, well, I need to actually complete that level if I want 100% completion. Obviously, that's not something I would do to actually, like, stock up on extra lives. Because Aztec games are a much easier way of doing that. Sunglasses were at the top, I think. Yep. Sunglasses in a stylish white case. Pugsanoid. This kind of sucks. I'm sorry. All right. Let's finish the level before I go back for more power-ups. Maybe having speed shoes was making that harder on me than it needed to be. Okay. Well, that's okay. Extra life. All right, Pugsanoid. You're a level in this game. I can say that much. Cool, cool glasses. Puggsy works alone. Except when he works with Ronaldo, which is all the time. So I guess it's just a matter of gathering together the 6 orbs and unlocking that door. I don't know if these pipes have a point or if they're crud. Or if they're just there to get in your way. I don't know what I do with the 6 orbs. I suppose I just set them next to the door where the number 6 is. I'm not seeing 6 orbs. Kinda odd that the secret exit is easier to get to than the actual exit. Or maybe I'm completely misunderstanding this level. So there's 3 orbs. So what happens if I throw the orb in one of these pipes? Alright. Came out the other side and it is still an orb. What happens if I throw it in the other pipe? Maybe it's not the number 6. Maybe it's Vi, like the text editor. Oh no. I don't know how you quit out of Vi. Okay. That turned into an extra life. Does that help me? I mean, does it help me finish the level? Okay, well, I can turn all of the orbs into hearts. I don't think that's what it's asking me to do. Very strange level. Maybe it's 6 divided by 2, which is 3. Like, maybe the question mark represents the denominator. But maybe they all need to be hearts, or they all need to be orbs. I don't know, this is the first time a Puggsy puzzle, or the first time in this playthrough that a Puggsy puzzle has truly, like, stumped me. Maybe something happens if I drop the pipe in the other tube. Like, maybe it turns into 2 things? And if I duplicate it, I can make 6 of them? Oh, it turned into a triangle. Ah, okay. So, a triangle has 3 sides. What's 3 times 2? That's right. 32. Puggsy is mathing his way to success. Hi. Okay, well, let's try dropping the triangle in the right-hand tube. Or maybe now I need to drop it in the left-hand tube again. I don't know. Let's find out. Okay, left-hand tube again. Okay, but now it's a square, so when I drop it in the right-hand tube, that'll turn it into a pentagon, and then when I drop it in the left-hand tube, that'll turn it into a hexagon, which has 6 sides. That's pentagon-esque enough. Yay! I solved a puzzle. Look at me. I'm glad I don't have to interact with any of the stuff in the background. That stuff looks super complicated. Alright. Finish up Rackrock Forge and defeat a guardian. These bears are feisty. Okay, I got a balloon. Nothing over there. Okay, a key. I figure that's important for opening that lock. Let's see what's up here before I flip that switch. I'm expecting that switch will drop me into that pit. Okay. So is it just a matter of bringing the key up there? Oh, okay. But there's no way to bring the key up there without flipping that lever. I see. So I need to drop the key down there, bring the balloon, and then float my way to freedom. Float your way to freedom the Puggsy way. And hopefully the key does not go flying back into the pit. I don't know. Oh, I don't know how to stop that from happening. I should have just let it hit the top. Where's my gun? How come the game's not giving me guns anymore? That makes these bears a lot easier to deal with. Alright, bear. I'll be back for you. Oh, you brought your friend. The only thing I hate more than a bear is two bears. Oh. Okay. Well, now I understand why those flame jets are there. Because floating out of that pit with a balloon is not going to work. I need to let the balloon bring the key to me. You think I would have realized that those flame jets are there for a reason, but puzzles. It's harder when the ground is uneven like this. All right, come on, grab the balloon. No, not like that. All right. Grab the balloon. Thank you. Oh, bears. If I have my gun, you'd be in big trouble. I guess I can just jump up there with the shoes. I was making it harder on myself than it had to be. This is a bear. Hello. You fool. Only bears may have bear powers. Run, 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 run. Sorry, that was probably a reference for like two people. Old internet memes and humor. Because I'm old. Huzzah! Right. A quote-unquote boss. Where's my stuff? So, I knew the Mega Drive version wouldn't have this boss, because it's FMV. But I didn't realize that the Mega Drive version was missing other bosses. Like, I kind of assumed it was just exactly the same game, except it didn't have the cutscenes or this boss. I mean, this is a cutscene. Let's be honest. Just don't get hit by the fire. All of the mechanical brilliance of an FMV game. In puzzle platformer flavor. I mean, I understand why people were fooled by FMV games back in the Sega CD days. Like, I was certainly fooled as a kid because it's like a cartoon in a video game. But as an adult, I now recognize that was a fake boss, and FMV games are fraudulent video games. I'll watch some FMV to see what's going on with the ship, though. Alright, it appears to be some sort of throne. Alright. So when I was a kid, I read that word as possessive. Reclante's docks. Like, there's someone named Reclante, and these are his docks. But now I realize that, obviously, that's supposed to be Reclantis, as in Raccoon Atlantis. So, I don't remember if I had that realization in the previous LP or not. Alright, new music. Awesome. Okay, we have a big old gap. Looks like I should be able to jump that. Is this another level that I can just skip over with shoes? That'd be fun. Oh, maybe not. Cause there's a fan there. Oh no! Okay, it's safe. So I'm going to need to light that cannon, bring the cannonball over to weigh me down so I can get past the fan. But it'll be a little bit easier with the shoes because I don't have to do the full route every time. The Lost City of Reclantis. Incredible. Okay. It looks like it would just let me jump right off the edge there. Yeah, I wanted to do the full route at least once to see the full level. But now I can grab that. Jump over here. Light the cannon, watch the ball fall down the pit. I suppose I was meant to catch the cannonball. Can I go down here, or is it death? It's death. Alright, I tried to pause so I could escape before I fully plummeted, but it didn't work out. So I guess I need to stand on that pillar, throw the cannon lighter into the cannon, and then catch the cannonball. Oh, Puggsy. Take that gun with you. He won't. Puggsy only uses guns as they appear to him. Alright, jump over here. Bop a raccoon. Grab that. Jump back over. Okay, so now let's get this seashell out of the way. So now I think I need to toss this into the cannon, grab the ball, and now I don't think I can jump across. I don't know, I might be able to. Okay, that works. Back off, buddy. I have a cannonball. See? It's worth 200 points. Hey, I hit 100,000 points. Look at me. Submit that to Twin Galaxies. Puggsy World Record. Okay. The spiky ball. Oh, I can't pick it up. It's too spiky. Okay, I see what's going on. I need to physics that spiky ball over to the right. Looks like there might be something up there if I like built a little tower. Huh. I don't know. I don't remember there being a secret level or a secret exit here. But all I need to do, I think, to finish the level is use a barrel to kind of nudge the spiky ball over to the right. And it might be a minor pain in the butt, but I don't remember it being too difficult. Nope, that's not how I wanted that to go. But I also kind of want to see if there's anything up here. Which involves my favorite activity, building a precarious stack. Ah. Oh, so close. I need to stack it one higher. It might just be like a one up there, or it might be nothing. Oh no. I can't stand on the topmost one. Ugh. Alright, now that I jump up there, I'm starting to think that's a red herring. But I've come this far. I must know the truth. Ah. Oh, this is not gonna work. And I nudged the spiky ball the wrong way. I'm probably going to have to start over. Yeah, it's nothing. Like, there's no way I can jump over to the right and get on top of that one. That's impossible. Okay, well. Curiosity satisfied. Nudge, nudge. Ah, crap. Nudge, 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 nudge. You can also get the spiky ball on top of a barrel like that, and it's still affected by gravity. That's a bummer. Nah. Yeah, the solution to this puzzle is all technique. You just gotta, do physics good. That's it. Like, there might be ways of making it easier on myself, but ultimately it all comes down to physics. Like that. Oh, I physics the hell out of that ball just now. Yeah, physics. Awesome. All right. Reclantis Maze. We have arrived. Been an amazing journey. Thank you for joining me on it. I kind of thought there were more enemies on this level. I thought there were dudes walking around. That's why I'm carrying a box of shoes. In case I need to chuck it at anyone. Oh, can I drop down through these platforms? I can, but I cannot bring the shoes with me. I chose poorly. I mean, do I even need to bring the shoes with me? I guess not. Alright, I can drop down there. Or I can follow this path. Okay, this rings a bell. Ah, it's just gonna be trial and error to figure out which one of these I need to fall down. So somewhere between the leftmost one and the two that are right next to each other. This should drop me down into a little alcove. Alright, so not the one on the far left. Messed up. Okay, but I know which one it is now. Simply the one second from the left. A nice chill level right before the final boss. Huzzah! Alright. Get ready to defeat Guardian. Item bonus none. It's Puggsy's ship. It's a massive raccoon. I saved a screenshot of it because I want to use that raccoon as my avatar again. Oh, okay. I remember. So just don't die, and bounce the lasers back at the boss. It's the not dying part that usually gets me here. Ah! Crud! Okay, so if I walk all the way over to the right, I think I'm safe from the other lasers. I might have to have a second take at this. Okay. So stay in the center. Ah! It's all the spiky balls' friends. They've come for revenge. Ah. Okay. Well, now I know how to solve the maze. It has a pair of shoes I can grab. But what happens if I immediately go down? Like, is that faster? No. It's a faster dead end. Maybe if I go this way? Yay! Okay. Oh, I won't have my cool glasses on when I defeat the boss. Oh well. It's the journey, not the destination. I don't know if that's applicable. It's a good thing he's not punching me with those massive metal gauntlets. I found your weakness. I'm taking you down, Reclanty. I still assume his name is Reclanty. It's Reclanty who lives at the Reclantis docks. Huh? He juked me. Just like The Legend of Zelda. The only way to defeat Ganon is by bouncing his shots back at him. Well, not The Legend of Zelda, like not the NES game, but many later games in that series. Boom! It's what you get when you mess with Puggsy's ship. Sucker. Alright, it's a little beat up, but it's no worse for the wear. This cutscene is off-center. Have they all been off-center? Yeah. Fuck that tower. You tell him, Puggsy. See you in hell, pale blue dot. Puggsy's back to wherever Puggsy's are from. Planet Pug. Nice. Well, I think I got all 51 levels. I sure don't remember any other secret levels. I don't know if it gives me like a bonus message at the end or what. Question mark? Will there be a Puggsy 2? Ah. Oh, it gave me my cool glasses. Puggsy has escaped with the spaceship and is off to view some more of the universe. Look out for Puggsy Part 2 coming soon. Sad trombone. Alright, well, thank you, John Burton, for all of your problems. Thanks, Will, for the awesome creature sketches. Thanks, Blythe Joustra for the music, Matt Furness, Steve writing. Puggsy has been Jamie tested. That's good. I'm glad Jamie approves. Thanks to Martin Chudley for Wiz and Liz stuff. MRC, maybe? Martin R. Chudley. Try to complete all 51 levels for extra ending. There are various hidden cheats if you can find the place to carry them out. A silly maths equation. Fiona, great cooking. Wow. Over 80 bad guys. A lot of bad guys. Oh, I found that. Wait, no, I didn't find Pugs in Space. I found Lunar Jet Pug. I forget what Pugs in Space is. Never raise or lower a stack of objects that you are carrying if you are walking left or right. Good advice. Stand just to the right of him when he fires his lasers. Yep, I made use of that hint. Each zone has 3 levels on it, so try to find all the hidden ones. If you find the hidden place, try taking out words like heroes for hidden features. Yeah, I tried. It didn't do anything. I don't know. Anyway, that's been Puggsy. Thanks for watching, everyone. There may be like a bonus episode at some point to tie up the loose ends. But after that, I hope you'll come back and watch something old or something new. Thanks, Ignosis. Thanks, Puggsy. Thanks, Traveler's Tales. And thanks to all of you for watching. Goodbye.